It's really different. Hello friends, in today's episode we'll discuss about a natural organic super growth enhancer which reduces the fertilizer usage by 30 to 40% and is proven to increase flowering and fruiting by up to 70%. How to use it and how much, coming up. When plants and animals die, their molecules become available in the soil for use by other organisms like bacteria and fungi. This product is the final breakdown constituents of the natural decay or decomposition of plant and animal materials through the biological activities of microorganisms. This product is commercially available in powdered form as well as in liquid form for horticultural use. So, how does this work on plants? It chelates the complex nutrient compounds in the soil to convert them into simple forms suitable for plant absorption. This reduces the fertilizer usage by up to 30% and increases flowering and fruiting by up to 70%. So, this is not a fertilizer, but a biocatalyst and bio-stimulant for the plant. This is an excellent natural and organic way to provide plants and soil with a concentrated dose of essential nutrients, amino acids, vitamins and trace elements. Before I reveal you the name of the product, let's quickly know some of the important functions or the benefits of this powder. One, number one, improves soil structure by providing more space for root growth and beneficial microbial activity. They bind to soil molecules and improve the soil structure. And this is especially noticeable in high clay and compacted soils. On number two, it reduces soil toxins. They don't just make nutrients easily available for absorption, but also chelate harmful toxins in the soil, preventing them from entering the plant. On number three, it increases water retention in the soil by reducing water evaporation by up to 30%. On number four, improved microbial activity in the soil and chelation of complex nutrient forms to simple forms for better uptake by the roots makes the plant grow healthier with little fertilizer application and increases flowering and fruiting. Having said that, let's know what it is called and how to use it properly for best results. This is called humus, which consists of three components: humic acids, fulvic acids and humin. This is available as powdered form and also in liquid form. The liquid is a concentrated humic acid and needs to be diluted with water before applying on plants. This should be easily available at your local garden store or you can even order online. Now, let's learn how to use it. This is particularly beneficial if your plant has nutritional deficiencies due to poor absorption of nutrients from the soil, which manifests as various leaf yellowing patterns. We have discussed this in a detailed episode. You can check that link in description below. So, how to use this? Three methods to use this. Firstly, soil application. The dosage is 1 teaspoon per liter of water. Mix it well and water 1 cup, that is about 250 ml of it per plant. You should see the results within 2 weeks. If you are using liquid humic acid, add 3 ml of it per liter of water. You should see the results within 1 to 2 weeks. Then secondly, it can be used as a foliar spray. You can add 1 teaspoon of this per gallon of water and spray on the plants. 1 gallon is equal to 3.78 liters. If you are using liquid humic acid, add 1 ml per liter of water for foliar spray. Please check the usage instructions on the product label and use accordingly. Thirdly, it can be used in compost tea. You can add 1 teaspoon per gallon to your compost tea while brewing. This will certainly help in better absorption of nutrients. For beginners, compost tea is made by adding compost like decomposed cow dung or vermicompost into water and allowing it to brew for 5 to 7 days and then you dilute this further like in 1:10 ratio and water your plants. Please like, share and comment below with your feedback and queries. Happy gardening!